Welcome to Newsclick and People's Dispatch. Today we have with us Anima, who's an advocate and who has been associated with the right to sit movement that has been originated in Kerala. So today we'll talk to her about this movement. So Anima, can you just tell us what is this movement about and how did it start?
It was started in 2014 in Calicut by the group of women workers called Penkota. It's a collective of women workers. They started this movement, and it was over the lack of seating facilities in textile shops. Mm-hmm. The women workers of textile shops are supposed to stand throughout the working hours. They're not supposed to sit. There are no seating facilities provided in the workspace. They're supposed to stand throughout the workspace. They work for some 10 to 12 hours. Throughout the working hours, they're standing. And due to the prolonged standing, they have serious health implications on their bodies. They have varicose veins, some of them have uterus problems, a lot of issues, and most of them are women, so they are suffering different kind of problems due to the prolonged standing. And this is how the movement started. After starting of the campaign by the Penkotas, two strikes happened in Alappuzha and Thrissur, two different districts of Kerala. Those sitting strikes, it was erupted in two different textile shops, big textile shops, where more than 200 workers were working. They demanded their rights, right to sit, and a lot of things were raised, right? Minimum wages were not provided. A lot of things were raised. Mm-hmm. No bonus, no minimum wage. The working hours were another problem, and no weekly off. A lot of labor right violations and fundamental right violations were also faced by the women workers in textile retail sector. All these were highlighted by sitting strikes. Mm-hmm. And
textiles രംഗത്ത് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മെയിൻ ആയിട്ടുള്ള പ്രശ്നം ഇരിക്കാൻ പറ്റാത്ത പ്രശ്നം തന്നെയാണ്. അതായത് കാലത്ത് 9 മണി ആകുമ്പോഴേക്കും ഞങ്ങൾ ജോലി സ്ഥലത്ത് ഒരുവിധം എല്ലാവരും എത്തും. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു 9:30 എത്തിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് 9:30 വൈകുന്നേരം 7:30 ഞങ്ങളുടെ വർക്കിംഗ് ടൈം. അത് ഒരുവിധം എല്ലാ തുണിക്കടകളിലും അങ്ങനെ തന്നെയാണ്. ഇപ്പോൾ കല്യാൺ മാത്രമല്ല, കേരളത്തിലുള്ള ഒട്ടുമിക്ക തുണിക്കടകളിലും അങ്ങനെ തന്നെയാണ്. ഈ തുണിക്കടകളിൽ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ പിന്നെ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഊണിന് തരുന്നത് അവർ അരമണിക്കൂറാണ്. ചായ കുടിക്കാൻ 10 മിനിറ്റ്, വൈകുന്നേരം 10 മിനിറ്റ്. 10 മിനിറ്റൊക്കെ പറച്ചിലാണ്, നമ്മളതിനുള്ളിൽ ചെയ്തു വരണം. ഇരിക്കാൻ പറ്റാത്തൊരു പ്രശ്നം തന്നെയായിരുന്നു വലിയ പ്രശ്നം.
സോ വാട്ട് വാസ് ദ ജേർണി ഓഫ് ദിസ് മൂവ്മെൻറ്റ്? ഹൗ ഡിഡ് ദിസ് യൂണിയനൈസേഷൻ ഓഫ് വിമൻ വർക്കേഴ്സ് ടേക്ക് പ്ലേസ്? വാട്ട് വർ ദ ചാലഞ്ചസ് ദാറ്റ് ദേ വർ ഫേസിങ്? കെൻ യു ടെൽ അസ് എബൌട്ട് ദാറ്റ്?
Earlier, it was Penkota. It's a small collective of women workers of unorganized sector. And even the formation of Penkota happened in 2010. They started a strike over right to pee, that there was lack of toilet facilities in SM Street, Calicut. It's a street in Calicut where a lot of trading happens. So it happened in 2010, and they started this right to peace strike. That is how Penkota was formed, and they right to peace strike was the first issue that was taken up by Penkota, the small group of small collective of women workers in the city. So the reason why Penkota was started was obviously the constant neglect of the mainstream trade unions. The mainstream trade unions were not addressing the problems of women workers, women unorganized workers.
Okay.
So there was no other option for them other than getting unionized themselves. So they were getting organized by themselves, and they started demanding their rights. That is how it happened. Otherwise, there was no union, there was no collective, there was no one to stand up for each other. Penkota is, it means women for each other. Women are standing for each other. The women workers started standing for each other. This is what the idea of Penkota. It was the idea of the women workers themselves. It's not that some external agency has influenced them or made them start up this, but it's a small forum, this Penkota. It was a small forum. Later on, they realized that they need a trade union. Then only they can demand their rights, because they have led so many strikes in the city. Later on, they realize that there is a need of union, because only a union can represent them in front of labor officers and labor courts or wherever.
Okay.
So they understood the necessity of a union. So they formed a union. It was AMTU. That's how Asanghadita Mekhala Tozhilali Union happened. Okay. It means Unorganized Sector Workers Union. It's Kerala's first women's trade union. It is.
I guess there were many instances where money was deducted from their salaries because they sat or just leaned against a wall. These kind of inhuman practices were being practiced in Kerala. So there are multiple issues with these workers, like you're saying, because they don't have access to toilet facilities and everything. But this somehow became the highlight of the moment, because I think it violates the fundamental right to sit. So how do you see that? Like, why do you think this has become basically the highlight of the
right to sit?
Right to sit, yes.
There are different issues that are faced by women workers, and this is, I think, most of the other issues that are raised by them, like minimum wage, bonus, and weekly off, the timings, everything. There are explicit law that speaks about their right. It is clearly provided in the Shops and Commercial Establishment Act of Kerala, Kerala state. It is clearly provided, it is clearly mentioned somewhere in the legislation, but right to sit is mentioned nowhere. So it's not explicit. It's not explicitly mentioned anywhere. But there is no law that says the workers should not sit. But at the same time, it's not explicitly recognized. This right is not recognized properly. So that might be the reason why they highlighted it. This was not the situation when there were only small and medium establishments. But when the big textile establishments started functioning in the city, in the state, it all changed. The whole work culture changed. The feminization of the labor happened. The feminization of the workspace happened. The employers started preferring women for this job, and because for various reasons, like cheap labor, it's easy to control women. Women will not bargain. They will not get associated with trade unions. A lot of things that attracted traders to prefer women over men. So the rapid feminization happened in textile retail sector, and they were not supposed to sit. And even when there is no customer, they are not supposed to sit. So they are supposed to stand. I mean, I have only a second-hand information. I've only observed it. They were not supposed to sit in the workspace. That might be the reason why they constantly get harassed. In case if they sit, there will be cameras in the workspace. So they're under surveillance throughout the working hours. So in case they sit, the people will notice it and come and shout at this woman, maybe harass this woman, and yeah, a lot of things happen. That might be the reason why they highlighted right to sit as a
basically, led the movement in a way.
Free time ila ayalum avarku nirikkana onnum sadikkilla full time nilpanna edu nera irunnittundengi appo avaru punishment tharum onnalengi avaru avadnu maattum alengi vilichu cheetha parayum adu customer nikkundu onnu nokkilla.
So now the Kerala government has acknowledged their demand, and they have passed an amendment.
Yes, there is an amendment. The amendment has come in 2015. Okay. No, not 2015, now 2018.
Okay. Yeah. And what does it promise to, you know, what all changes has it brought?
Actually, there is explicit provision that speaks about right to sit is there in Factories Act, which is not applicable to the unorganized workers of textile retail sector, but there is explicit provision.
Okay.
The Factories Act, 1948 Factories Act has well incorporated the concept of right to sit in the statute book, but Kerala Shops and Establishment Act doesn't have it.
Okay.
So, Factories Act, it was explicitly says that if the nature of the work permits, a seat should be provided throughout the working hours. If the nature of the work does not permit to sit, there should be a seat in the reasonable proximity in the workspace itself, so that the worker can make use of any opportunity to sit during spare time.
Okay.
So this is how it's in Factories Act. Similar provision has incorporated in Kerala Shops and Commercial Establishment Act now. So it's there now in it. And it's a huge victory of the workers and their fight. Yeah.
Now that's about Kerala. If we speak about other states where, for example, Karnataka, where textile is a very strong sector, do you see anything happening there, or is it the absence of women's unions that is responsible for absence of such a movement in other states?
Yeah. The situation, we all know, we all go to textile shops and we all know that they are not provided. If you can just check whether there is a seat. No, there won't be a seat. So the situation is same in everywhere. I mean, we all know that. But of course, I have only a peripheral idea like you when it comes to other states, because I haven't studied it. But the situation is almost same. Shops Act comes under state list. So other states should also incorporate the concept of right to sit anyway.
And now that it has happened in one state, maybe there's
maybe other
workers from the other states.
Yeah. And among factory workers, I think, I mean, the textile factory workers, there are unions that organize women factory workers in Bangalore and all. But I don't know whether they are organizing the textile retail sector workers.
Okay.
I mean, retail sector workers.
Right. Yeah. Thank you for watching Newsclick and People's Dispatch. Yeah.